We've had a few showers from the outer rain bands of Cristobal in some of our southern counties, but other than a little bit of heavy rain for the next few hours, the rest of that activity should diminish overnight. It's really not going to be until tomorrow that we're going to get the bulk of our effects from Cristobal, but we are going to have some significant issues, especially with rain and gusty winds. Those are going to be the main problems. Right now, as of 4 p.m., 50 mile an hour winds for Cristobal, and you can see it really spinning around here in the Gulf, and it has sped up a little bit. It's moving north at 12 miles an hour. Now, with the projected landfall time frame of the late afternoon and early evening right along the central Louisiana coast as a medium strength tropical storm with winds of about 60 miles an hour. For us, the main impacts are going to be late tomorrow through pretty much all of Monday, but we are going to see Cristobal get pretty quickly taken out of our way by the jet stream. Once we get into Tuesday, everything will be starting to calm down. But we are in prime position for some seriously heavy rain. Some spots might even get more than 5 inches of rain, especially towards South Mississippi. So that'll be the biggest concern for us. But Cristobal is going to make landfall tomorrow evening. Heavy rain and gusty winds will start late tomorrow, but primarily we'll be dealing with them into Monday. And the heavy rain, the biggest concern, we're also going to be dealing with pretty consistent 15 to 30 mile an hour winds across the entire area, with gusts as high as 40 miles an hour and maybe some spots getting even higher winds than that. It does look to be very calm, though, in the short term here. Really not going to see a whole lot of rain until tomorrow afternoon, maybe a few showers in the morning, but it's really not going to be until the afternoon that things are going to start to ramp up for us here. By the early afternoon, outer rain bands start to roll in with some heavy rain. We'll be dealing with that for the bulk of the afternoon on and off, but the core of the storm is not really going to approach until we get into the late evening and overnight hours. But you can see some very, very heavy rain will be starting to move in right around midnight, early Monday morning. And then we get it for several hours, and especially south of I-20 here, this is where we see the bullseye of very heavy rain for the course of several hours. Flash flooding may be possible in some spots due to all of this very heavy rain because it is going to continue through most of Monday. At least for Monday afternoon, we're going to kind of be on the edge here, but this outer rain band may be a little bit problematic in the form of brief weak spin-ups. That does tend to happen as these tropical systems lift out, so that will be an additional concern. Heavy rain, though, and flooding will be the primary concern for everybody here, especially south. You can see a bullseye here of 5 inches or more of rain in some of our southern and eastern counties, and that may even need to be shifted a little bit further north because it looks like we are going to get some bouts of very, very heavy rain. Gusty winds, too, a big problem for us. These are future wind gusts throughout tomorrow afternoon. You can see towards the south already starting to get some of those 40-mile-an-hour winds. For us, most of that will come on Monday as the storm moves right through our area, but going into Tuesday, everything will start to calm down a little bit. There still probably will be a few gusty winds out there, but the bulk of all the action will be tomorrow night through Monday night. Tonight will be warm and muggy and getting windy, especially south as Cristobal gets a little bit closer, feeling very tropical with lows near 73. Tomorrow we should manage to make it to 87 with good breaks of sunshine, but the scattered storms are going to start rolling in with the heavy rain. And it's going to be very windy tomorrow. Gusts of up to 30 miles an hour possible. And we'll see that for sure on Monday and Tuesday. As Cristobal gets lifted away, it will be a little less windy, but still going to have that breeze of anywhere from 15 to 30 miles an hour. A few showers there as well. Wednesday, we have a cold front coming. This one actually going to move all the way through and give us several very nice days for the end of the week. Low humidity and cool mornings.